Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to construct an activity diagram for online flight ticket reservation system or online reservation system, either the way you can call that. So let's get started. So for doing this diagram, I am going to use the Star UML software. You can use any other software or online tool that you want. So if you are using Star UML, first thing you need to go to model, you have to click on add diagram, and here you will be having this activity diagram. Just click that. And once you click that, you'll be having all the necessary shapes and things to construct your activity diagram. So in the activity diagram, we will be just beginning with this big black dot called as initial. So let me just click that and go to the top. Yeah, so this is going to be the starting point. So whatever may be the online system, the first thing that a person does is register or login. So it's basically like you create a new account or you're going to sign up with your existing account. So this is what I'm going to do. So let me just have an action. But first, this is going to be, login. Now this is good. This is the first action. We just now drag this here. And next one, we are going to have two conditions in login. Okay. One thing is the user is going to be an existing user. Another condition is the user is going to be a new user. So in case if the user is new, the user must first register and then only the user can log in. So in that case, we will be having a yes or no condition over there, which is kind of a decision. Okay, we are making a decision where the user is, you know, a new user or an existing user. So we will be having a decision, which is a diamond shaped thing. I can say that this, or maybe like a tilted rectangle or something. It has four sides. So yeah. So this is going to be the decision, and let me just have a text over here. For doing text, we need to go to annotations, and let me just have here a text, and let me type it as new user, and let me just have a condition over here also, another text. I will just have here no, which means that the user is an existing user, no here, and I will just have another text, which is yes, which means that the user first register and then only, you know, log in again. So I'll just have here register. I will just draw the arrow lines in a minute so that, you know, it makes better idea of what I'm doing. So I will just draw like after some time, not in the yet. Okay. So it's going to be register over here. Yeah. This is for if the user is yes. So this is the thing that we're having. This is the yes or no clause. So I'll just be having register over there. So let's imagine that the user is already registered and it's not a new user. The next action that the user will, or the system will do is going to be authentication. So basically, you know, the system will check in the DP whether that email ID entered is the right email and the password entered is a right thing or not. So it's basically just validating or verifying your credentials that you have entered. Basically just the email or phone number and the password. That's going to be authentication. That's perfect. And here also we will be having two conditions. Okay, one is validation successful, and one is validation failure. What I mean by validation successful is that if the user has entered the right credentials, right email and the right password, which means that the user is authenticated to go inside the website. Just imagine as if you are signing into your Google account, exactly the same thing. And what I mean by validation failure is that if you are entered the wrong password or the wrong email, you won't be permitted inside your account, right? That is validation failure. So in case if there's a validation failure, we will be again directing the user to a login. So where the user can, you know, forget password, do those things and like get back another password and log in again. And if the user validation is successful, the user can just go into our website. Simple. So let me just have here another text, exactly the same thing that we did for new user. So here we are going to have it as validation and same decision box, because here we are making a decision, okay, whether it is valid or invalid. And I would also recommend you to start your diagram from the top so that, you know, you have some space, enough space at the bottom also. Don't start in the middle, you won't complete your diagram. And next thing is going to be same thing, valid and invalid rather than yes or no. Going to be valid, and have it here. And next text is going to be invalid. Yeah. So if the user is valid, and here what we will do is we will use this thing called as fork, and we use this thing called as fork whenever there is a flow of control to multiple actions. So in this case, after login, basically the user can book tickets, book flight tickets, check for the seats, search for the flights, view the online ticket history, check the bills, cancel tickets. So there are like so many actions a user can do, because it's like an online airline system, right? So there are multiple things that a user can do. So basically, from the login, the control is going to shift to multiple actions. So in that case, there is a split in action. For that, we will be using this fork. So here you can see that this one arrow line, and it just goes into multiple arrow lines. So that's what this means. So just have it and expand it a bit like this. This is fine. So now let me just draw the arrow lines for this so that it makes better sense. So we will be having this control flow thing over here. So first thing, from our start to login, this is fine. And just next is going to be from login, and here we will have a check for new user, and if that user is new, we will just go and ask the user to register. And once the user registers, the user can then just login. This is done. And if the user has already logged in, the system will authenticate the credentials, the email and password. And if the user has entered the right credentials, the user will be permitted to enter our system. Just goes here to place it perfectly on that. Yeah. And if the user has entered some irrelevant or wrong credentials, the user will be prompted again to go and log in. So this login is kind of difficult. You have to have like this, and you have to select that line, and you have to like drag it this way, something like this. Okay, this is, yeah, this looks much better. You can just, you know, straighten the lines and do those things. That's not important. Yeah, this is much better than that. So now let's go into our first action as a person who is going to book a flight in the online reservation system. First action is going to be enter the destination, enter the details. Okay, so first is going to be enter details. So you can just have it book ticket or something like that, but yeah, I'll just have it enter details and book ticket. Yeah, two things. Yeah, just have something like this, because for booking the ticket, the user needs to enter everything, like the date, time, the place from the user is going to like board the flight, and arriving destination of the flight. So everything, so the user needs to first enter the details, then only the user can search the flight, right? You can't just go and search the flight's name, Boeing or something like that. You first need to enter the destination, the place we are going to board the flight, the price, everything. You need to just enter every criteria, and then only you can search the flights. So once you have entered the details, it will be there, then the user can search for flights, search flight. And after that, once the user has searched a favorite flight, the airlines, we have so many airlines across the world, right? So once after doing that, the user can just book seats. If the seats are available, the user can select them. And yeah, and another thing what you can do is you can even have a similar thing over here. You can even have a decision thing saying after search flights, you can have a decision box saying that no seats. If there are no seats, means the user will again continue to search the flight. If there are enough seats, the user can seats. So it's just exact same thing. You can just have a diamond decision box over here. I'm just keeping that because it's fine, it's enough. So once the seats are booked, then the user will make the payment. Payment is made by card. You can't do cash, I guess. You need to go in person to do a cash payment. Most of things will be done online. So after payment, and after payment, a notification will be sent. That's also important, right? The ticket, a e-ticket or notification will be sent. So just have notification over here. Notification. over here. This is fine. And after this, if the user has come and got the necessary tickets for the required destination, after this the user can just log out. So for that, what we can have is we will be having this join thing. This is also exactly similar to fork, but they look the same, but they have different meanings. So I will just go here with this join thing. And after the joining, we will be just having a final action, which is log out. So I'll just go here and put log out. Yeah. So this is the thing over here. And this is for the first action. I am made to show you like 2 to 3 actions more. And next action is going to be view history. Okay, this is going to be just a straightforward action, view booking history, because this is just, you know, the past actions, the past payments and past everything. So the user can just, you know, view the booking history. So after viewing the booking history, the user can just log out. This is just a direct exit. That's it, in case if the user has come only to view the booking history. And next one is going to be edit details. Edit customer details. You can just have it enter details. Yeah, that's perfect. So edit customer details, what I meant is that the email ID, the mobile number, the address. So in case if you're booking some flight tickets, you need to enter your address also, in case if your luggage or cargo misses. There are some cases they may like courier it to you, right? So you need to also have your address, email, phone number, all those details, medical conditions, I guess. I don't know, some details. So in case if the passenger wants to edit the details, they can just enter it. I think customer spelling is wrong. Move this over here. Yeah, this is fine now. Edit customer details, and this is also directly log out. So once the user has, you know, edited the details, the user can just directly log out. This is also another action that the passenger can do. This. And next one is going to be canceling the tickets. So the user will also have an action to, you know, check the current status of the ticket. So it's going to be current status. So in case if that particular flight is available, there aren't any, you know, because of some cyclones, the flight could get canceled on that particular day, or the user may have some other plan. So after booking a particular ticket, the user will have some status whether the ticket is active or not. So if the ticket is active, if the journey of the flight is yet to begin, the user can still, like, you know, cancel the ticket like two or three days before the flight. I don't know how many days before, but the user can still cancel the ticket. So we'll just have a current status, and inside that the user will be able to view the current ticket, and the user can cancel the ticket. So this is based on some conditions, differs from airlines to airlines, how much days prior of your journey you can cancel your ticket. So after that, you'll be getting a refund, and you'll be getting a refund, and you'll be getting a notification for that. And after these are done, this takes time, you know, notification, this refund takes time, and maybe like this is done by the systems, just don't include that. After that, you'll be getting a notification saying your ticket has been canceled and your money will be refunded. After that, the user can just log out. And the final one is going to be this final thing, just have that. And you can just have a control line for that. Yeah, so this is basically the diagram, and I need to draw from this too. Yeah, you can just have it this way. And this is a diagram that I have done over here. And if you have any comments, and if you also want to add some other use cases, you can just let me know in the comments. And mine is a programming channel, by the way. Do check the playlist. I've also done many other use case diagrams, activity diagrams, and class diagrams for many other online systems, as well as programming tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL, Spring Boot, queries, as well as CRUD operations. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.